Yep. You're alive. Should be working now. Sweet, sweet, it's working. All right. Looking good. Looking pretty good. Yeah, so I've been playing Xenoblade Chronicles X. And checking out these new settings to see if they work out. Get into it. I'm only gonna be playing for a couple hours. Because I got stuff to do in like 2 hours. But all things considered, I probably should be able to get through the first chapter of the game. At least try to get to a certain point where I can stop. But this is a good game. This is a real good game. This is fun. I don't need the net. It's fine. Playing offline. Let's go new game. Actually, I'm gonna let title screen roll because it's pretty. It's a pretty, pretty title screen. Oh, bam, baby. Oh, it just looks so good. Like, this is my kind of game. This is like sci-fi, mechs, interesting story, cool characters, create your own characters. This. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful kind of game. So, get into new game. I have no idea if this stream is actually going to hold up. I kind of feel like... Oh! Thanks to the sub, Cherry! Yeah, I'll be responding to chat throughout the entire Let's Play. And I'm going to be playing as much as I can before I have to go off and do work. Yeah, I'll disable auto power. I'll be playing the whole time anyway, no point. But, yeah, testing audio, making sure everything working pretty well. Let's see. Yeah, it seems fine. Fine. I'll try to be quiet during cutscenes, but if there's something that does catch me off guard, I will laugh at it. Or, you know, be surprised at it at least. But generally, I'll try to be as respectful for the cutscenes as possible. Because, like, we're both enjoying this game together, you know? Like, I don't want to be that dude at the cinema who yells. Or, like, sexy phone or something. But if I plan on doing something like a little bit intense, like loud, like type my keyboard, I will mute my mic. Sure. I didn't actually check if the subtitles would fit. Should be okay. Should be fine.
July, 2054 AD. The Earth was caught in a great battle between unknown alien forces. Their weapons were terrifying and powerful beyond human reckoning. Our planet was overrun. Its surface reduced to ash and rubble in the blink of an eye. The Coalition government knew the war was coming. In response, they prepared the Earth Life Colonization Project, Project Exodus. Interstellar arcs were launched all across the planet, from every major city on Earth. Bravely, we leapt from our cradle, our home for the last 4.5 billion years. But most of the arcs never even made it out of the atmosphere. Only a small handful managed to escape. Among them was our ship, the White Whale. After leaving Earth behind, we spent 2 years wandering in space, searching. We thought of ourselves as the lucky ones, the pioneers who would settle a new world. But our past caught up with us, literally. The alien blitz was unrelenting. If not for the efforts of a lone hero, we would never have survived. Our ship took heavy damage. We lost control. With our flight systems down, the White Whale was pulled into the gravitational field of a nearby planet, its hull shattering and breaking to pieces as we plummeted toward the surface. Since then, 2 months have passed.
Pretty cool. It's a very Gundam vibe, if you know what I mean. Whoa, create a character. Let's go. So, I want to try to make them look like me as much as possible. And by as much as possible, I'm not going to play a female. As much as I love playing, like, I love playing females in MMOs and stuff. But I think for this playthrough, I kind of want myself in the game because there might be potentially romance options. And I'd like to be able to romance, pick a waifu, you know, that kind of thing. So, none of these faces really look like me. Ugh, no. God, no. Nah, not feeling that one. This is gonna be a while. I'm gonna be stuck on this screen. Kind of why I'm scared to play. Fuck, that doesn't look like me. Jesus, I might be old, but I'm not that old. Come on. Yeah, that's too old. I'll just do the default face and then just change the hair. So, the size is fine. Oh, you can change the background. It's pretty cool. All right, I gotta change the hair. Whoa, that's some serious bed hair. I'm not feeling that one. No. Maybe? Actually, that one's pretty close. I want to get rid of that, though. Now, the thing is, if I change it to black... I think that one's closer. I think that's more closer to my hair. I'll do that one. Alright. Eyes. I'll give him normal eyes. And black eyes is fine. Yeah, it looks pretty cool. I like it. I like this character. I don't think he needs, like, any of that stuff. Alright, so the voice now. So, you know, I could go for the old English style, but I kind of want to do a different one. So let's check it out. Voice sample.
V victory is ours.
Nah, I don't want Sasuke in here.
Come on, I'm off balance.
Easy peasy, rock and roll. Easy.
Yeah, we'll work well together.
There's no substitute for real combat.
Ah, not liking these ones.
Huh? Let's do this thing.
No.
We'll work well together.
Let's get this started. No. Rock and roll.
Yeah. This one's pretty cool. I like this one.
Cheers. Sorry. Cheers. They staggered me. Shall we?
Oh, it's between Rebel and Classic. Classics? Uh-huh. I'll go Rebel. I'm liking Rebel a lot. Cherry, there is no Koi style. Like, a Koi style? If there was an Australian option, like a Bogan option, maybe. But right now, I've got Rebel, and that'll do. I think that's it.
Attention, external access confirmed. Disengaging stasis in 10 seconds. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Releasing hatch. Please stand clear.
Hey there. Looks like you're all in one piece. Careful. Just take it nice and slow, okay? Your senses will need time to reactivate. Your pod is the only one around that landed intact. Good thing I found you. My name's Elma. You want to tell me yours? You don't even remember your own name? It must be the stasis hangover. That's not good. Just try and focus, all right?
All right, let's put in my name. Thanks, Cherry. Posting my stream onto your Discord. Love ya. Love you so much. Alright, so let's just put my name in. K-H-O-I. I'm using the gamepad, by the way. That's why you can't see it on the screen. But it's fine. So, put some in. There you go. Nice and simple. Nothing too major.
Good. There we go. What else you remember? It'll come. In the meantime, I'll get you up to speed here as best I can. How are your limbs? Can you move?
Yeah, I can move. I can move my arms, legs. I'm standing right now, so I'm assuming I'm pretty okay. Hey Cherry, how's the audio from the game? Is it alright? Like, I'm a bit worried that it's like a little bit too low, a little bit too high. I think it should be enough. I did a little bit of test before I started streaming, but I can't be too sure exactly. So let's go. I'm gonna nod my head.
We'll take it easy while you shake the stasis out of your system. One step at a time, all right? First things first, you'll be needing a weapon. There you go. All right, let's get going.
All right, let's. Thanks, Sherry. So pretty much we're in the tutorial sort of thing. Elmer's advice, follow the arrow. Take a moment to check the mini-map if you're ever stumped. Following the yellow arrow should reveal the way forward, though an occasional excursion off the beaten path never hurts. You know what they say about all work and no play after all. Thanks, Elmer. Let's get straight into it. So, straight into gameplay. Let's go. This is... So, what I like about Xenoblade, at least for the first one and this one, is it feels like an offline MMO. Like, the battle system, at least. It's just, it's more in line with, auto attacks and making sure you use your skills at the right time. Positioning. It's very similar to MMOs, or at least... You know, the only MMO I play, which is FF14. It's a lot of similarities with that. So, I dig this. I dig this system. So.
Most of the white whale's life pods didn't survive the crash. Like this one. You're one of the lucky few. Right. You don't even remember the White Whale, do you? You know, the L002? The ship we escaped Earth on? You remember Earth, right? Planet Earth. Your homeworld. Or rather, it used to be anyway. Unfortunately, it was caught in a battle between two alien forces. And destroyed. Ring any bells? Don't feel bad. It's one memory I'd like to forget. I know. It's been following me for a while now. I didn't want to alarm you, but we're going to need to defend ourselves. You up to the task?
Alright. Cherry, my friends are all busy, I think. Today is my day off from work, so I thought I'd stream. And I thought I'd try to get into the habit of at least streaming as much as I can. And I thought this way I'd get through games and stream and talk to you guys, talk to everyone, and also get in the habit of uploading more to YouTube. So it's a win-win in every way. I have plans around 2 to help out a relative, so I'm gonna be a bit busy there. So I'm only gonna be streaming for a bit. Oh. Sorry, the battle music. Oh, the battle music, so good. Oh, Hiroyuki Sawano, you musical genius. Yeah, I've been working a lot overtime, actually. It's good, you know? It's good. I you know, work's work, I've got to pay the bills, and, you know, got to do stuff. So, let's get straight into the game, though. Elmer's advice, target and draw. Initiate combat by targeting enemy, then drawing your weapon. Now, what do you say we give it a whirl, I'll be here to back you up, so feel free to experiment. So, we got targeting, and then target and draw. So, let's go. So, as you can see, I'm auto-attacking. I've got selectable skills on my hotbar. Flame grenade, which I think is just straight up DPS. And a dot. And also assault hammer, which includes topple. So it's like a stun. So it's a straight up flame grenade. And that should kill. Good stuff, good stuff.
You're not half bad. There's plenty of work back in the city for someone who knows how to handle a weapon, you know.
Yeah, sure. Works work. Get some money.
Then you're interested. In that case, I might have just the job for you. But anyway, we can talk more details later. For now, let's keep moving.
Alright, so like in every RPG, you kill an enemy and you get loot. And let's see what this thing's guns. Yeah, I'll take it all. So let's get to the menu real quick and check out if I can equip that stuff. So let's say check out ground gear. Here's me. Can I equip it? No, I cannot. Oh, I can. No, I cannot. I don't. It's different class. Pretty useless. So let's go explore for a bit. Actually, before I do anything, I need to save. I think it's important I save because, you know, I don't want to restart all over again. All right. So let's get into it. Okay. Some loot. I got prototype battle armor. Body armor. Let's check that shit out. So this is gonna be my stream. I'm gonna be just looking through menus a lot, but you know, I hope you guys enjoy my banter, my talking. It looks okay. Doesn't look too bad. Glam game. Glam game. You know, I gotta look good when I'm fighting monsters. I wanna turn off the, there's a setting that makes it so you could- Yeah, that's it, it's fine. There's a setting that makes it so you could take off your helmet. I wanna see my face the entire time. Because I wanna see the emotion from my character. Like, a lot of games, when you have, like, a helmet on, it looks kinda goofy. Like, I get it, it's a helmet. It's supposed to, like, protect you. But, like, during cutscenes, if they're trying to exhibit emotion, you just see, like, a flat face, it's just like, that's the same if you're wearing a helmet. I don't know what you're seeing. Like, I don't know what you're feeling. So, I like it. I like the option. I appreciate the option of being able to turn off your helmet. Let's take up this bug. Yeah, buddy, let's go. I can switch to melee, I think. I can, yeah, melee, let's go.
Looking pretty sharp.
Okay, this voice is pretty stupid. I'm okay with it. Oh, I messed up. Dinner is served? What the? This voice is. What the hell? Okay, this voice is okay. It's a bit goofy. This voice is a bit goofy, but it has its moments. Pretty closer to me, actually. Pretty close. Can you die, bug? Can you let go? Just wanna hit you. There you go. Hit him. Class rank up. I'm assuming it's like my subclass or something like that. Those are a bit scary. All Okay, I can run. I can sprint. I can jump really high. Oh my god. It's pretty cool.
Let's get this started.
Let's see what you've got. Shadow strike. Sliding slinger.
Jesus Christ, Elma. Like, calm down.
We got it. Let's move.
Open fire.
Oh my god, you can jump while shooting? It looks goofy. It's pretty good. I'm just level grinding to get like a little bit more stronger before I start doing it. And my cord got stuck on my toe just now. You can't see that because the webcam is focused on my face. I'm hoping to get at least past the first chapter before I take a break. Once I get home from my business stuff, like I'm not working today, but I want to help out family, you know? Like, yeah, it's my day off, but it doesn't mean I get to like stream all day. But I do want to like help out family. Like that's a good part of me, like trying to help out family. But I do want to like get through at least the first chapter of this game. At least make it to whatever that arc looking thing is. Because I remember playing this. I played this game like when it came out at launch, but I never got to finish it because it's so big. And unfortunately, my save file got bloody deleted, and I don't know how. Like I think it was because my USB drive just failed. And it bummed me. I didn't want to play it anymore, you know? Like, I sunk in so much time. What was that? Was that a flashbang? What was that? Flame grenade. Get out of here. Freaking shoot you down.
Nice work.
Get a load of this.
Let's see what you've got.
I'm going for the melee. Oh, so it's acid bolt that's freezing me. And bolt strike. Okay, so yeah, it creates a stun. Makes sense, makes sense. Just kill him. Oh wait, I've got melee. So I changed to my hotbar. More damage from behind. Ah, oh, crap. Never mind. Stone Potamus. Let's try that shit out.
Send them pack. Take it in close.
Now it's my turn.
Dude, this music is so good. Why doesn't Haruki Sawano make more game music? Like, this should be proof enough that he's awesome at it.
So you like knocking people around?
Like, more sci-fi, man. Whoa, what is happening over there? Boost damage, let's go.
We got him. Let's move.
Nice. Nice.
Let's get this started.
They're off guard. Stack them to melee attack.
Cherry, how have you been? Ooh, haven't heard from you in a while. Like I know you started playing FF14 and like you got membership and stuff, but I haven't really heard anything about you. So how have you been? How did I fail that? What? Come on. Whoa, what is happening? What? His voice is so good. He's like dumb. Alright, let's check out the prototype sleeve, worn sleeve, more defense. Yes please. Yes please. Oh, you have a job? That's good. Job's a good. Music die? No, we're good. Alright.
Let's
Oh, because there's multiple sections on this one enemy. So that's why it's like freaking out. Whoa. Alright. Did I miss something? I feel like I missed something. I did. Gotta get the loot. Prototype boots. Booties. Let's check this out. It's better. Straight up, it's better. Always pick the better option. Unless it looks really ugly, then you reconsider it very, very, very intensely.
Let's get this started.
Let's see what you've got. Nice. Move in and do some damage.
Whoa, what is this? I think that's the distance, pretty good.
Use an aura. Get control of the battle.
Flame grenade.
Alright, so there's another chest over here, so I'm gonna check it out. Yeah, there it is. Can I just jump to it? Whoa! Pretty big jump. Wait, where is it? I see it, right? Oh, there it is. Iron knife. Let's check that out. Jerry, how's this setup? Does it look better? Like, does it look a lot more cleaner than my old setup? Because my old setup was pretty a lot. Like, there was a lot happening. And, oh shit, I didn't even check the stats on it. Oh yes, that's fine. It's like, I'm hoping to just make this a little bit more simple so I can, like, put this on Twitch and also put this on YouTube and all that kind of stuff. Look smooth? Damn, that's pretty good then. I think I'm gonna stream more then. I mean, sure, this isn't great. Like, my net could be better, but this is fine. As long as it's not lagging. And I'm recording at high quality too. I messed up. I was too busy talking and I wasn't paying attention. Man, my Let's Play ability is still lacking. Still needs more work. Needs more power. Come on. Give me that flame grenade. Come on.
Flame grenade. Now, topple him with some gunfire.
I'll topple him.
Easy peasy.
Easy peasy.
Let's move.
Send him back. Take it in close.
Now, it's my turn.
Come on. Damn. We good.
We got him. Let's move.
All right, let's go check it out. So there's a like a objective marker over here.
Rain's starting to let up, just in time for sunrise. Follow me. I promise you're gonna love this. wild, huh? They're all indigenous, as far as we can tell. We need to learn to play nice with these guys if we're going to try and coexist together. Call this planet Mira. You won't find it on any star chart. But it's our new home. Recognize the habitat unit? That's where we're headed. Watch yourself. That first step's a doozy. We can jump if you like. You could handle the fall. But the indigens down there are another story. Some big, some mean, all nasty. Given our options, the high road here would be the safer way to go, relatively speaking. That said, whichever way you want to go, I'll follow your lead. You decide.
Alright, Elmer's advice, sprinting. If we want to reach the habitat before sundown, we'll need to pick up the pace and start sprinting. Sprinting is good for times when you need to get somewhere in a hurry, or when you need to break out of an especially hairy situation. But we'll sprint by left-clicking the left analog stick and auto-run. So it's like an MMO in a way, like there's an auto-run feature, which is pretty cool. Like I said, this game uses a lot of MMO sort of like systems, and it just works, and it's fun. It kind of reminds me of like Phantasy Star, like a little bit of Phantasy Star vibe, which is cool. Phantasy Star's cool. I'd like it if they'd release Phantasy Star Online 2 here, but you know, that's wishful thinking at this point. Look at this guy. The white whale's habitat unit over there to the east. If you keep proceeding along the clifftop, you'll be able to reach it without much difficulty. Thanks, Blade. And female Blade. If you fall off a cliff, don't panic, just head east until you reach the habitat. And try not to engage any powerful enemies on the way. Oh! Enemies. Let's take
get this started.
Engaging. Lay down some fire for me.
Oh, now it's like bright and stuff. So good. No more rain.
Now, melee attacks.
Lock this.
Oh, I messed up too early. Side attack.
Nice work.
Oh, got some gear. Let's check it out. Is that like no difference? So this knife is more accurate, but I lose damage. I'll take the old knife. Oh god, that looks ugly! Oh, I'm so glad you can take off the helmet thing. See what I mean? Like, that helmet looks ugly, man! It's like a bootleg Doom guy helmet. So let's go along the cliff face. Wait, let's look around for a bit. Look at this game. It's pretty. Really pretty. Oh, don't fall off now, Koi. Damn, this game looks pretty. Looks gorgeous. I want to take out this stupid brass femina suet. Whatever that means. Oh, whoa. Calm down. What do you want? You picking a fight? I'm actually shocked the stream is working. Like, it seems to hiccup every now and then, but all things considered, this is working really well. I am not picking a fight with that thing. I'm definitely not picking a fight with that level 5 over there. Should be able to do enough damage on it.
Don't push me. Easy
peasy. We got it. Let's move.
Damn. All right. Wait. I got a new art? Yo. New class as well? Class abilities? That's not bad. Oh no, it's raining again. I don't want it to rain. Can I go and like change the weather settings? So I don't want to, because I want to play this game in like the sun, please. Actually, can I just switch it to like 9 a.m. or something? Because right now in the game, it's afternoon. Man, get your afternoon showers out of here, man. I think it's this thing. There it is. Yeah, there you go, yeah. I don't want late night, though. About 9 a.m. Yeah, no more rain. All right, so let's get back into it. God, the jumping is so cool. Like, it's so unnecessary. Look how big. Look how look, freaking woohoo! It's so dumb. I love it. Alright, let's go beat up some more monsters and then get straight into the story mission.
Open fire. Follow me.
Target in sight. Shadow strike. Side flash.
Alright. Charging up the iron knife. Get in the... I can't believe I missed that twice. Like, come on.
Nice work.
Take it in
now,
close.
It's my turn.
I wonder what the difference between like this one and the brass. Like this brass one and the other one I just killed. Is one female, one male? There's a lot about this world I don't know. So I'm curious. I'm not a biologist, don't get me wrong, I don't do biology, but I'm curious, is like, you know, do I have to farm one, do I have to farm another? Oh my god, my character saying dinner is served is so confusing.
Strength comes from experience.
What? Well, Elma just leveled up. Sweet. Alright, let's take out this level 3.
Get a load of this.
Let's see what we've got. That put a dent in him. Move in and keep the rhythm going. Sliding splinter.
Come on, Elma. Whoa! What the f- Oh god, there's one behind me. I just want my side attack. Just keep attacking. Whoa, knockback. Oh my god, this music though! No! So good!
Nice work.
Alright. I am not bothering that level 5. Get out of here. I should be okay, like in terms of levels, I should be pretty good. Keep running. Nothing much. I can dodge that level 4. Ain't gonna bother me. Alright. I remember playing. Is this just a warthog from Halo? Look at it. This is just a warthog. I'm gonna loot the shit out of it, man. The level 1 mechanical. It gave me an assault rifle. Let's check it out. God, that helmet looks so dumb. Yeah, it's better. Whoa. So, I lose one defense, but I get more... resistance. Sorry to say this, but the dumb helmet's staying, because it's going to give me more defense. And defense is what I need. Holy shit, I almost fell off. Oh, fuck. Oh, scary. I don't want to fall off. Music though. Damn. Nice. I got another arc. I'm happy with this style. I can do more of these Let's Play streams. Gives me a chance to like really finish these games, so it's a win-win. What was it? Was there another? Is there a path up there? Oh shit! I shouldn't have tried to explore. And it's raining now. God damn it. I got one-shotted. Where am I? Oh my god, I'm at the start. Oh my god. Am I? I am at the start. Oh my god. I should not have tried to pick a fight with that level 24. What was I thinking? Well, I want it to be 9. Thank you. I want it to be sunny, and I'm gonna go straight to the end. I've level grind enough, not enough to kill the level 24, but enough to get at least to the habitat. Jesus, I was not expecting a level 24 to be hidden up there. And one that aggro so easily, like, I was just walking. pretty dumb. That's dumb. That's funny. It's dumb, but funny. Alright, let's go straight to the... Wow, you little shit! What's that one? Recuperate! I can heal! Sweet, I got a healing. Wrong side, buddy.
Nice work.
Gotta say, this blade's looking pretty sharp.
No, I'm not attacking that thing. Going straight to the end. No explorerinos. Going straight to the end and finishing off this story. Leapfrog! Oh my god, he is up there. Oh shit, I should have noticed from here. Level 22, sneaky butt. The West Gate Plane. Snail little losers! I'm going straight to the freaking objective marker! Well, there's the gate.
Looks a lot bigger up close, doesn't it? And this was just the habitat unit. The White Whale was one hell of a ship. Until it all came crashing down, at least. That's the West Gate. It's closed off now for security reasons. But we've repurposed a freight elevator that will get us inside. Rexes. Ryle. Take them down. You ready?
All right. First boss battle. Three of them. Is that one down? That's one down. Dude, shooting my gun in the air. Oh crap.
Shadow strike. Upper hand.
Side attack.
It's a shame we had to settle near so much wildlife. Luckily, some species aren't so hostile, but they aren't necessarily friendly either. I've come to learn that there's a fine line between self-defense and provoking a fight. We need to walk that line. All right, let's head in. Who knows? Maybe seeing the inside will jog your memory.
That's some survival boots. Let's check that out. Better. Hands down. What? What's with these pants? Oh man, glam game's off point. Ah well. He's looking stylish. He's looking like he's gonna go to a disco. At least that's Whatever. I'll get new pants soon anyway. Let's check out this place. Warthogs?
Thanks.
Thanks, Piers. I'll make my way up myself, thank you. So cool. Like, the vibe of this game is so cool. Alright. Let's go.
Well, here we are. Not too shabby, huh? For a giant beached spaceship, anyway. But, like it or not, this place is our home now. We took the name from the city it was modeled after back on Earth. We call it New Los Angeles. Welcome to NLA.
So it was that another survivor came to join our band of refugees. Together, we resolved to forge a new way of life here on Mira, come what may. New LA was our beautiful lie to ourselves. Truth is, we were adrift, heading into the unknown. Our native home was gone, swallowed in a shroud of light. And our future was uncertain. We had no idea what fate lay in store for us. Only that we had to keep living in order to see it.
Prologue. That's a good prologue. That's a good prologue. Alright, I'm gonna save here and, pretty much just take a break. I got stuff to do and I'll be back to stream more later tonight. Pretty much, yeah. So, I'm gonna be streaming a lot more later tonight once I get back from my pretty much my house duties. I gotta make sure I gotta do them first. Anyway, hope you guys like the first part of my live Let's Play. I had Cherry in the chat most of the time. Well, pretty much the whole time. Keeping me company. And, you know, for these live Let's Plays, I was thinking of doing two things. I'll respond to chat, obviously, if it's about the game. And if it's, like, you know, something funny, something makes me laugh. And like, I might have some guest people come in and keep me company in voice chat, but I still haven't, like, found anyone yet, so I need to really make sure, be careful who I bring on, because I don't want to pretty much ruin this whatever I've got right now. And how I feel about the first part of Xenoblade Chronicles X. That's a hell of an intro. Like, first of all, it sets up the tone, sets up everything. The world's hostile, as you can tell from that level 22, that which just destroyed me with one hit. And I mean, I really like just the style of it. It reminds me of Phantasy Star, and the graphics are great. For Wii U, this looks freaking amazing. It's exceptional. And you can tell that they did some tricks to make sure to, like, to make it run smooth and all that kind of stuff. So, anyway, I'll be back later, and, you know, this first part's gonna go straight onto YouTube, and I'm gonna do my live stream again. I'm gonna announce it, like, every time, if I'm gonna be live on Twitch. And make sure you go to my Twitter, like my Twitter, like, follow me on Twitter, Facebook, all that kind of stuff, and, I'll be pretty much just announcing when I'm gonna be live. That's it. That's all I need to say. Anyway, I'll catch you all later in the next stream, and, yeah, hopefully this all worked pretty well. I'm gonna be, like, pretty much looking over it and making sure everything works. So, anyway, catch you later. Peace. See ya.